بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الف لام ميم تلك آيات الكتاب الحكيم هدى ورحمة للمحسنين الذين يقيمون الصلاة ويؤتون الزكاة وهم بالآخرة هم يوقنون أولئك على هدى من ربهم وأولئك هم المفلحون صدق الله العظيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. The beginning of Surah Luqman is very similar to the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah. Many of you might have recalled. There we have Alif Lam Mim Zalika Al-Kitab La Rayb Fih Hudan Lil-Muttaqeen. Here we have Alif Lam Mim Tilka Ayatul Kitab Al-Hakim. These are the ayat or the revelations of a book which is wise, full of wisdom. Hudan wa rahmatan lil muhsinin. It is a guidance, and not only a guidance, but a mercy, but for those who attain to the level of excellence about their religion. In Surah Al-Baqarah, it is muttaqeen. That's the starting point. Hudan lil muttaqeen. It is a guidance for muttaqeen. But now it is muhsinin. Those who have attained excellence in this deen. For them it is rahmah. Hudan wa rahmatan lil muhsinin. الذين يقيمون الصلاة ويؤتون الزكاة وبالآخرة هم يوقنون. Who establish the prayers and they pay the zakah and they are absolutely convinced of hereafter. Here actually the word yaqeen is used. يوقنون. They are fully convinced that another life we shall have and we shall be resurrected from the dead. And then the life of the Akhira, that is the real life. As we read in Surah Al-Ankabut, وَإِنَّ دَارَ الْآخِرَةَ لَهِيَ الْحَيَوَانَ لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ. Actually, the house of Akhira is the real life, only if they had known. أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَىٰ هُدًى مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. These words are exactly the same as we find in Surah Al-Baqarah. They are the people who are on guidance of their Lord, and they are those who will attain salvation and prosperity and success. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَشْتَرِي لَهْوَ الْحَدِيثِ. And from people there are some who go and buy frivolous discourses. I will explain it, what it means. لِيُضُلَّ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. So that he leads astray people from the way of Allah, from the path of Allah without knowledge. بَيَتَّخِذَهَا هُزُوَا. And they take this, that is Quran, the ayat which are being revealed to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, in a mockery. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ مُهِينٌ. Those are the people for whom there is going to be humiliating chastisement. Now this has been the practice of the evildoers in all times. Keep the common people busy in such things that they don't listen to something which is serious. They don't have a time to ponder over serious things. Keep them busy. Either, you know, in playing, singing. So there was a person, Nadr ibn Haris, who was amongst the very staunch enemies of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When he saw that the people of Quraysh at Makkah, they are attracted by Quran. They go to listen Quran from Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. To distract them from that, he brought a singing girl from Persia. And the stories of ancient Persian history. And he said, read these things. Don't pay attention to what Muhammad is saying. These stories are much better than what Muhammad is relating. And go and listen to this singing girl. You will enjoy. Why do you go and listen to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? And in this our present age and civilization, these games, you know, they have been designed by Satan to keep people busy. Either you work hard for earning, or you are just enjoying life and busy in the external world. You never have an opportunity to peep down your own hearts, to search your own souls, to think about who we are, where we are, where we are heading, what is going to be the end, what is happening, why it is happening. Are we having humiliation in this world? If it is so, why? What are the reasons? Never think about it. Be, eat and drink and be merry, or if you have some spare time, well, keep attached to the television or watching the baseball game and so forth and so forth. So these are the tactics of those people who want that the message of Allah should not spread among the masses. وَإِذَا تُطْلَى عَلَيْهِ آيَاتُنَا, and when our ayat are recited to him, وَلَّا مُسْتَكْبِرًا, he turns away in arrogance. قَالَّمْ يَسْمَعَهَا, as if he had not even listened to them. كَانَّ فِي أُذُنَيْهِ وَقْرًا, as if there is some heaviness in his head, in his ears. فَبَشِّرْهُ بِعَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ, so O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, give him the glad tidings of a painful chastisement. Now this is a taunting attitude. Glad tidings, not warning. But you know, for them the glad tidings are those of painful chastisement. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتُ النَّعِيمِ, as for those who come to believe and do good deeds, for them there will be the gardens of bliss. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا, they will abide there forever. وَعَدًا عَلَيْهِ حَقًا, this is a promise true on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ, and He is almighty and all-wise. خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ بِغَيْرِ عَمَدٍ تَرَوْنَهَا, He has created the heavens without any pillars that might be visible to you. وَأَلْقَى فِي الْأَرْضِ رَوَاسِيَا, and He has fixed mountains on the earth. أَنْ تَبِيدَ بِكُمْ, so that it should not shake with you. وَبَسَّ فِيهَا مِنْ كُلِّ دَابَّةٍ, and He has scattered and spread in this earth all types of animals. وَانْزَلْنَا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً, and we sent down water from heaven. فَأَنْبَتْنَا فِيهَا مِنْ كُلِّ زَوْجٍ كَرِيمٍ, and then we caused to grow therein of every noble kind of growth. هَذَا خَلْقُ اللَّهِ, this is all creation of Allah. فَأَرُونِي مَاذَا خَلَقَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ دُونِهِ, now let me see what those other gods have created, whom you think that they are also associated with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بَلِ الظَّالِمُونَ فِي ظَلَالٍ بَعِيدٍ, nay, these evildoers are in a very clear error. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا لُقْمَانَ الْحِكْمَةِ, this second section, it mentions Hazrat Luqman. Who was he? Two things are clear. He was neither a prophet of Allah, nor he was from the ummah of any prophet or messenger. He was a simple person. As you know, the traditions go, he belonged to Nubia. Nubia is a place, desert, between border of Sudan and Egypt, somewhere in between the two. He belonged to this Nubia place, and he was dark-colored, Abyssinian type of people. And he lived in Mecca, and he was a carpenter by profession. But he was a wise man. Now what is wisdom actually? It is composed of two things, because this section is included in our selected course of study of Quran. It's number lesson number 3. So this is very important, because the basis of Quranic philosophy, those articles are contained in this section of this surah. What is hikmah? وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا لُقْمَانَ الْحِكْمَةَ أَنِشْكُرْ لِلَّهِ, and we had granted wisdom to Luqman, that be thankful to Allah. وَمَنْ يَشْكُرْ فَإِنَّمَا يَشْكُرُ النَّفْسِ, and whosoever is grateful and thankful to Allah, he does it for his own gains. وَمَنْ كَفَرَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ حَمِيدٌ, and whosoever is ungrateful, Allah is self-sufficient, he doesn't need any thankfulness or some reward from any person, and he is praiseworthy. Now two things we have to keep. One is the nature in us. And what is that nature? Actually, it's the ruh that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has grown unto us. This nature, this ruh, it has the dormant consciousness of Allah and love of Allah. It is there, ingrained in this nature of human you know, human beings, because every human being has a ruh in him. But then there is another thing, and that's the faculty of reasoning, which we call aql, the intellect. Now, if the two conditions are fulfilled, a person's nature is safe, sound, healthy, not perverted, and his intellect is also working in the correct direction, then he will reach, he will think over, who am I, what is this universe, has it been created by itself or someone has created? If someone has created, who is he? What are his attributes? How can I love him? How can I worship him? And what is going to be the end of my life? I eat, drink, live, and then die, that's all. Or there is going to be some result of what I am doing here. If I do something good, shall I get any reward anywhere? If I do something wrong, am I going to be punished somewhere else? Now, these are the basic questions. Basic questions of philosophy, of metaphysics. So if a person, he might not be very much learned, and you know, he might not have a couple of PhDs with him, but if his nature is safe and sound, and his intellect works in the right direction, he will reach certain results. And what are those results? They are given here. When Luqman was dying, you know, he transferred the result of the fruit of all his thoughtfulness over the whole of his life to his son. The sermon to his son, you know, that has been mentioned here by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this person, Luqman, was very well known in Arabia. Just as we quote in our speeches, Allama Iqbal, he said so. In the same way, the khutaba, the orators, and the shuara, the poets of Arabia, used to quote him as a very wise person. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is here giving the person to whom you accept that he was a wise man. Well, actually his position was this, that we are telling you. And this is the same, fundamentally, to which Muhammad is calling you, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا لُقْبَانَ الْحِكْمَةَ نَشْكُرْ لِلَّهِ. The result of hikmah is that we should be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The nature, if it is correct, it is safe, it is sound, it is healthy, it demands that if somebody does any good to you, you must be thankful to him. If you are thankless, your nature is perverted. But who is the real benefactor? How do we know? This material world, the sun, the moon? No. Someone else. Someone who has created the sun and moon. So we should be thankful to him. Just as Ibrahim said, إِنِّي وَجَّهْتُ وَجْهِيَ لِلَّذِي فَطَرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ حَنِيفًا وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. I reject the stars, the moon, the sun, and I have turned my face towards in the direction of that who has created these heavens and earth. وَإِذْ قَالَ لُقْمَانُ لِبْنِهِ. The call when the Qad said to his son, وَهُوَ يَعِذُهُ. And he was exhorting him. يَا بُنَيَّ لَا تُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ. Now the first result of this wisdom and thankfulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should be not to make anyone or anything an associator with him. لَا تُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ. He is alone, he is one. He has no partner, no equal, no associate. إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. Verily, associating something or someone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a very big injustice. وَوَسَّنَ الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ. Now, in between the advices and sermons of Luqman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is adding, because he has said to his son, you should be thankful to Allah, and you should not associate anyone with him. Now Allah is saying, وَوَسَّنَ الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ. And we have enjoined upon human being that he should be kind to his parents. This is also parents have a right. Your creator is Allah, but who bore you in this world is your mother, and who cared for you, for your needs, when you were a child, are your parents. So you have to be thankful to me, number one. I am the creator. I have put this love and affection in the hearts of the parents for you. But then you should be thankful to your parents also. And we enjoined upon man concerning his parents. His mother bears him despite weakness upon weakness. حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ وَهْنًا عَلَىٰ وَهْنٍ وَفِصَالُهُ فِي عَمَيْنٍ. And his weaning is in 2 years. Now what we have said? Give thanks to me, anishkur li wale walidek. Be thankful to me, grateful to me. I am the creator and I have put this affectionate love in the hearts of the parents. But now actually that affection has come to you through your parents, so you should be thankful to your parents also. إِلَيَّ الْمَصِيرُ. In the end, all of you will be returning to us. وَإِنْ جَاهَدَاكَ عَلَىٰ أَن تُشْرِكَ بِي مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٌ. The same thing which we have read already in Surah Ankabut. But if the parents pressurize you, they strive against you and pressurize you that you associate with me anything or anyone about whom who have you no knowledge, فَلَا تُطْرِهُمَا. Then you don't obey both of them, disobey them. وَالْمَصَاحِبُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفَةً. But even then, you should keep an honorable company with them and gentle company with them in this world. وَتَّبِعْ سَبِيلَ مَنْ إِنَابَ إِلَيَّ. And you should take to the path and follow the path of that person who has turned towards me. You don't follow your parents. Be kind to them, respectful to them. This is their right. But follow if they are on the right path. Okay? This is Nurun ala Nur. If your parents are on the right path, this is Nurun ala Nur, light upon light. But if they are on the wrong path, they are not to be followed. You have to follow the one who has turned his face towards me. ثم إلي مرجعكم. Then all of them will have to, all of you will have to return to me. فأنبئكم بما كنتم تعملون. And then I will tell you what you had been doing. يا بني إنها إن تكو مثقال حبة. Now again, the sermon of Hazrat Luqman starts. Oh my son, little son, إِنَّهَا, if it is, what does it mean? If a good deed or a bad deed, if it is إِنْ تَكُمْ مِسْقَالَ حَبَّةٍ مِّنْ خَرْدَلٍ, if it is of a weight of a grain of mustard seed, very small, human deeds, they might be very small, good or bad, however small they might be, فَتَكُنْ فِي صَخْرَةٍ, or though they may be in some rock, of a samawat, or in the heavens, of a lard, or in the earth, Allah will bring it. Ya tibihallah. All deeds will be brought on the day of judgment, and you will have it. Well, we have it in the last para. Misqala zarratin khairan yara. Faman ya'mal misqala zarratin khairan yara. Faman ya'mal misqala zarratin sharran yara. If you have done, even you know, equal to the weight of zarra, an atom, you will see it. Inna Allah latifun khabir. Verily Allah is very subtle and aware of everything. Ya bunayya, oh my son, aqim as-salah, establish the prayer. When you have come to know Allah, He is the creator, He is the sustainer, now you establish a psychological relationship with Him through salah. Go on, addressing Him, praying Him, 5 prayers a day. Why? So that you remember. Aqim as-salat al-zikri, we have read it in Surah Tutaha. Aqim as-salat al-zikri, for my remembrance. Aqim as-salat wa'amur bil ma'roof, and enjoin upon others whatever is good. Wanha anil munkar, and forbid them from whatever is evil. Wasbir ala ma asabak. And then you have to bear with patience and perseverance whatever comes on you. Because when you will enjoin people to do good, maybe some people are angry with you. When you stop people from doing something bad, maybe they beat you, they come on you, they attack you. So all these things can happen. Because truth is bitter. Nobody is going to like this. So then you have to bear with forbearance and patience whatever comes to you. Inna dhalika min azmi al-umur. Verily, these are the matters requiring strong character. Only a person who has a strong character can do these things. وَلَا تُصَعِبْ خَدَّكَ لِلنَّاسِ. And don't turn your cheek away from the people haughtily. وَلَا تَمْشِ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحَا. Don't walk on the earth in a boastful manner, haughtily. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ كُلَّ مُخْتَالٍ فَخُورٍ. Verily Allah doesn't love anyone who is arrogant and boastful. Waqsid fi mashyik, and be modest in your way, gait and walking. Waghdud min sawtik, and lower your voice. Inna ankara al-aswat ila sawtul hamir. Definitely the most unpleasant voice is the braying of the donkeys. Alam tarau anna Allah sakhkhara lakum ma fis samawati wa ma fil ard. Don't you see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has subjected to you and to your service whatever is in the heavens and whatever is in the earth. وَأَسْبَغَ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَهُ ظَاهِرَةً وَبَاطِنَةً. And He has perfected upon you His blessings, whether they are visible or invisible. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يُجَادِلُ فِي اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. And there are people who argue about Allah and fight about Allah and argue against Allah, although they have no knowledge, وَلَا هُدًى, no guidance, وَلَا كِتَابٍ مُنِيرٍ, nor any book which is bright and illuminating. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمُ اتَّبِعُوا مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ. And when you said to them, we should follow what Allah has sent down. قَالُوا بَلْ نَتَّبِعُوا مَا وَجَدْنَا عَلَيْهِ آبَانَا. They said, no, we shall follow on what we have found our forefathers. But for their practice, we shall continue. أَوَلَوْ كَانَ الشَّيْطَانُ يَدْعُوهُ مِنْ عَذَابِ السَّعِيرِ. What? Will they keep on following their forefathers? Although it is possible, it might be, that the Satan had been calling them to the chastisement of the blazing fire. وَمَنْ يُسْلِمْ وَجْهَهُ لِلَّهِ وَهُوَ مُحْسِنٌ. And whosoever surrenders and submits his will to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he has attained excellence, فَقَدْ اسْتَمْسَكَ بِالْعُرْوَةِ الْوُثْقَى. So now he has his hand on the firm handle, hand hold. وَإِلَى اللَّهِ عَاقِبَةُ الْأُمُورِ. And definitely, the end of all the affairs is with Allah. He will decide. وَمَنْ كَفَرَ فَلَا يَحْزُنْكَ كُفْرُهُ. Whosoever disbelieves, so O Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, don't grieve over it. إِلَيْنَا مَرْجِعُهُمْ. They have to come to us. فَنُنَبِّئُهُمْ بِمَا عَمِلُوا. We shall tell them what they had been doing. And we shall recompense them. We shall reward them. We shall punish them. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. Verily Allah knows what is in the chests of the people. نُمَتِّعُهُمْ قَلِيلًا. We are providing them for this life. But what is this life? A few days, few years, that's all. نُمَتِّعُهُمْ قَلِيلًا. ثُمَّ نَسْتَرُّهُمْ إِلَىٰ عَذَابِ الْغَلِيسِ. And then we shall harshly, and we shall drive them, push them, towards the harsh chastisement. وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهُ. And if you ask them, who has created the heavens and the earth, they will surely say, Allah. قُلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ بَلْ أَكْثَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Say, then praise, all praise is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But most of them don't know. لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. To Allah belongs whatever is there in the heavens and the earth. إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْغَنِيُّ الْحَمِيدُ. Allah is free from all needs. He is absolutely self-sufficient. And He is the praiseworthy. وَقْلَوْ أَنَّ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ مِنْ شَجَرَةٍ أَقْلَامٌ. Now this subject has already come first in Surah Kahf. وَلَوْ كَانُ الْبَحْرُ مِدَادًا لِكَلِمَاتِ رَبِّي لَنَفِدَ الْبَحْرُ قَبْلَ أَن تَنْفَدَ كَلِمَاتُ رَبِّي وَلَوْ جِئْنَا بِمِثْلِهِ مَدَدًا. This ayah in the end of Surah Al-Kahf. This subject is being repeated here. وَلَوْ أَنَّ مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ مِنْ شَجَرَةٍ أَقْلَامٌ. And if all the trees on this earth become pens, وَالْبَحْرُ يَمُدُّهُمْ بَعْدِهِ سَبْعَةُ أَبْحُرٍ. And the ocean, and to it are added 7 more oceans, and they work as ink. مَا نَفِدَتْ كَلِمَاتُ اللَّهِ. The words of Allah will not be exhausted. And I had explained at that time, what does it mean? Every creation of Allah is the result of His word, kun. So all the creations, they are words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When He decides something to create something, it says kun, and it becomes. So these are the words of Allah. So by these words of Allah, it is meant here is the creations of Allah. You can't count them, you can't write them. Impossible. مَا خَلْقُكُمْ وَلَا بَعْثُكُمْ إِلَّا كَنَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ. Your creation of all of you, and your resurrection of all of you, is nothing but like the creation and resurrection of a single soul. It's so easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He can create you and recreate you. Then, and it is for him as easy as creating one human soul. Inna Allah Sami'un Basir, verily Allah is all listening and all seeing. Alam tara anna Allah yulaju al-layla fi an-nahar. Don't you see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala merges the night into the day? Wa yuluju an-nahara fi al-layl. And sometimes he is merging the day into night. Wa sakhara ash-shamsa wal qamar. And he has subjected the sun and the moon for your service. Kullun yajri ila ajalin musamma. Every one of these is running its course for an appointed period of time. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. And that whatever you are doing, Allah very well knows it. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْحَقُّ. And this is because Allah is the truth, the whole truth. He is the truth. هُوَ الْحَقُّ وَأَنَّ مَا يَدُونَ مِن دُونِهِ الْبَاطِلِ. And whomsoever they are calling besides Him, they are just falsehood and nothing else. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْكَبِيرُ. And that Allah is the one who is great. أَنَّ اللَّهُ هُوَ الْعَلِيُّ الْكَبِيرُ. High and great. أَلَمْ تَرَى أَنَّ الْفُلْكَ تَجْرِي فِي الْبَحْرِ بِنِعْمَةِ اللَّهِ. Don't you see that the boats and ships, they sail in the sea or in the rivers بِنِعْمَةِ اللَّهِ, with the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لِيُرَيَكُمْ مِنْ آيَاتِهِ, so that He shows you some of His signs. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِكُلِّ صَبَّارٍ شَكُورٍ. Verily in this are signs for those who are persevering and grateful ones. وَإِذَا غَشِيَهُمْ مَوْجٌ كَالظُّلَلِ. But when they are in sea or ocean, and when a wave covers them like clouds, it's a very high wave is coming, just as the clouds, you know. دَعَوُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. At that time, they call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, promising Him their total obedience. مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُمِ الدِّينَ. We shall obey you, O Allah, and none else. Please deliver us from this the affliction which is coming. فَلَمَّا نَجَّاهُمْ إِلَى الْبَرِّ. And when Allah delivers them to the land, فَمِنْهُمْ مُقْتَصِدٌ. There are among them, they start some in between. They worship us also and others also. And they take the middle road. وَمَا يَجْهَدُ بِآيَاتِنَا إِلَّا كُلُّ خَطَّارٍ كَفُورٍ. And our ayat are not rejected except from those who are unfaithful and ungrateful. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ. O mankind, have fear of Allah, your Lord. وَخْشَوْ يَوْمًا. And keep fearing that day. لَا يَجْزِي وَالِدٌ عَنْ وَلَدِهِ. When the father will be of no avail for his son. وَلَا مَوْلُودٌ هُوَ جَادٍ عَنْ وَالِدِهِ شَيَّا. Nor the son would be of any avail to his father. إِنَّ وَعَدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ. Everyone will have to bear his own burden. Everyone will be accountable in his individual position. كُلَّهُمْ آتِيَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَرْضَ. We had it in the end of Surah Maryam. إِنَّ وَعَدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ. This promise of Allah is true. This time is coming. It will come. It is to come. فَلَا تَغُرَّنَّكُمُ الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا. So let not the life of this world deceive you. وَلَا يَغُرَّنَّكُمْ بِاللَّهِ الْغُرُورِ. And let not that biggest deceit, arch deceit, that is Satan, deceive you by pleading Allah is all-forgiving. Now this is one of the very big, you know, ways of deceiving of Satan. He says, Allah is forgiving. Okay, go on doing what you are doing. You are eating haram, okay, go. Allah is forgiving. He will forgive you. So this forgiveness of Allah is forgiving. But Allah punishes also. He is unkaqam also. Although He is ghafoor, but He gives you punishment also. So that is, you know, we have to keep in between. We should keep on hoping for the forgiveness of Allah, but keep on at the same time fearing the chastisement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bain al-khawf wa al-raja. We should keep our position in between. The fear, there should remain. But hope that Allah might, Allah may. Hope, Allah may forgive us. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عِنْدَهُ عِلْمُ السَّاعَةِ. Verily, it is only Allah with whom is the knowledge of that hour, when that hour, as-sa'ah, will come. Only He knows. وَيُنَذِّرُ الْغَيْثَ. And it is He who sends down rain. وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي الْأَرْحَامِ. And knows what is in the wombs of the mothers. وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتُ. And nobody knows, no soul knows. مَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ مَاذَا تَكْسِبُ غَدًا. What that soul is going to earn tomorrow, some good deeds or bad deeds. وَمَا تَدْرِي نَفْسٌ بِأَيِّ أَرْضٍ تَمُوتُ. And no soul knows in which land it will die. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمُ الْخَبِيرُ. Verily, Allah is the all-knowing, all-aware.